I can give traveling and give some brief background of this package. So PyHealth is our newly developed package, and we have kind of almost finished all the key functionalities. So we plan to give like weekly or bi-weekly like this kind of PyHealth live session to give you some background of our package and some newly developed functionalities like gradually. And for this week, this is the first session of PyHealth Live, and we will mainly use this presentation slides. And maybe starting from the next session, we will use Jupyter Notebook and use this real live demo to present the basic modules in the package and some advanced use cases. Yeah, that's pretty much the plan. And we plan to make these sessions to be as short as possible. For example, this week we probably will use 30 minutes, and it won't be longer than 1 hour, I guess. So the topics to cover for the next few weeks, we will announce those few future topics in our website and in our GitHub README files. We will soon release that. Right now, we haven't kind of finished the planning. Yeah, I think that's basically the background. Oh, professor is joining. So
I think we can get started.
it's almost 8. We can get started. And so for the new audience who just come in, I just want to mention, okay, this is the first PyHealth live session. And for the next like in the future, weekly or bi-weekly, we will continue these sessions to tell you the basics of PyHealth and also some newly developed functionalities with real life Jupyter Notebook demo. So and we will release the future planning topic in our website and also the GitHub README file. So that's pretty much it. And it's already past 8. We can get started. So PyHealth is a, sorry, you want to say something, Professor?
Hey, Chanzi. Yeah, I think we're super excited. I saw some names I don't know. Is it Jing Yuan and Ying Hao? And thanks for joining. I think the rest of the team I know, right? They pretty much this is their show. I'm super excited and see their initiative to organize this and have the passion to build this package and help other researchers. I think they will tell you why we built this, right? I actually didn't go through this slide very carefully, but I'm super excited. And if you have questions, feel free, I guess, to put in the chat. And I think Chaoqi will also mention some resources, right, to have people to join and participate, contribute to the PyHealth development, or ask questions or submit issues. Okay, I'll just hand it over to Chaoqi and team.
Thanks for your introduction, Professor. So if you want to really look at the details into our PyHealth, you can, like during my presentation, you can just simply search PyHealth in Google. And I believe the first item you will find is our read the docs documentation. So I will get started. PyHealth is a comprehensive deep learning tools for healthcare predictive tasks. And I am Chaoqi Yang. I'm a PhD student from UIUC. And currently, this package is continuously maintained by Zhenbang, Patrick, and me. And I'm hoping like Zhen in this call will like also join us and help us developing this package. So the next slide, this is the overall overview of our package. Right now, in our package, we can support several like open electronic health record data sets, such as the popular Mimic3, Mimic4, and ESU data set. We are also able to support the standard medical OMAP CDM-based data sets, as well as any different types of customer data sets. So in the package, we can also support right now more than 15 clinical predictive tasks, such as drug recommendation, length of stay prediction, and phenotype prediction. So right now in the package, these task definition are more as an example for users to try on. And we borrow the definition of the task from the recent literature. But if the user want to try their own definitions, we welcome, and then just follow our template and design your own task definition on that data set you just processed. For the healthcare AI models, right now in the package, we support more than 25 healthcare AI models, including deep learning models such as the CNN, RNN transformer, and other standards deep learning models, and the specialized healthcare AI models such as Retain, Dipo, GameNet, and other models. So some models can only work for one data set and for one specific task, such as GameNet. This is a special model for drug recommendation task. And other models are general enough to handle most of the other tasks, such as CNN, and Transformer, and Retain. So the first three key features are for building the machine learning models. The last feature is related to medical code mapping. This is more like a auxiliary functions. So with our package, we are able to handle to master more than 10 medical coding system, including ICD-9-CM, ICD-10-CM, ICD-9 procedure code, ICD-10 procedure code. The first two are diagnosis code and coding system. The second two are procedure coding system. And also some drug and medicine coding systems such as NDC, RX norm, and ATC. So broadly in that medical coding functionality, we can support the lookup functions in the medical coding space, such as you give us the name of one coding system, such as NDC. You want to look up one code in NDC, we can help you to retrieve the parent node in the NDC ontology system, and the sibling node and the children node, as well as the detailed descriptions for each code in that coding system. The second big functionality is that we have various cross mappings between medical coding systems. For example, you wanted to find, you have a NDC medical code, you want to find the corresponding code in the RX norm code. You just simply load our modules and use it as a dictionary to look it up. Give us a source code, we can help you to map it to the target code. So with all these functionalities, our goal is to support both medical practitioners from the clinical space and the deep learning researchers from machine learning academia. So for medical practitioners, we will expect they are not experts in building deep learning models, but they still want to try some fancy deep learning model to see whether they can help in their clinical research space. So we hope our package can let them to quickly build up a very quick prototype pipelines in their research and to try the newly developed machine learning models in their task. And for deep learning researchers, all of our modules have provided very flexible, customizable choices for them to turn the knob and then to choose the best settings for them to customize their own healthcare deep learning pipeline. So in the next slides, I will present three key features in the current PyHealth version. So the first feature is that we kind of unified the data processing for all different data sets. We have stored one data sample as a JSON structure, as I have shown in the right-hand side. So this JSON file is just one data sample, and we record the hospital visit ID and the patient ID for this data sample. And these two attributes is used to do data splitting into training, validation, and test sets like in the next stage. And the following attribute here the conditions, procedures, and what other bunch of possible features are the predicted P features that your deep learning models will rely on to predict the final target. And the final attribute is basically the labels, the predicted target. These labels can be a binary value, can be a multi-class value, can be a regression value, can be a multi-label values. So this unified like JSON structure can support all different scenarios and different medical healthcare tasks. So the second features in the current package is that all our modules, they are independently callable. And I have listed some in the right-hand side, the PyHealth dataset, PyHealth modules, and the PyHealth metrics. So for example, in your own pipeline, you have built a novel models for some task, and you want to try whether these novel models is gonna work. So you have to build up your own pipeline. You have to process the data set, try the model on, do the training and evaluation and test, but you don't want to waste the time on data processing. So how our package can help you? You can simply use our PyHealth.dataset, these modules alone, to process the data set. For example, Mimic is your target data set. You can use this to process Mimic data set and then directly concatenate your undeveloped novel models on top of it. That will save the time for data processing. For another example, if you already process the data sets, you already have these JSON structured samples here, and you want to quickly try some novel models, such as transformer models or LSTM models, then what to do using our PyHealth, you just load your data set, wrap it as a data set structure in our package, and simply initialize a model from PyHealth.modules, and then train it automatically using our package. So I will give several examples in the next few slides. The third key features of our package is flexible code mappings, as I mentioned before. So we provide two large modules. One is internal map and another is cross map. So for internal map, we can retrieve the parent node, the sibling node, the children node for you with respect to that specific code. And we can also list all different descriptions for that medical code for you. For the cross map, we have already preloaded several medical coding mappings from one system to another system. You just need to simply search and specify the source coding ontology system you want and the target ontology system, and give us the code that you want to map. We can map one by one using our dictionary mapping. And I will give us some examples in the next few slides. So these are the three key features of this package. Okay, the installation of the package is, you can install it from two different sources. You can simply run pip install PyHealth from PyPy, or to use Git clone, clone our whole repo to your folders and compile it in your local environment. So every machine learning pipelines, at least most of the machine learning pipelines, can be formulated in this way. You can treat it as data processing stage, task, build a machine learning task on top of a data set, and then initialize the model, train the model, and do inference or evaluation, these five stages. And for each of the stages in our package, we provide one specific models related to that. And if you wanted to use our package, you just regularize your own pipeline into these five stages and plug one or more modules into your pipeline. For example, you have everything ready, but just need to process data set, then use our PyHealth data set for your first step, and then run whatever you want on top of the first step. Or if you have a data set already processed, and you have a specific machine learning task already defined on top of the data set, you just need to run a simple quick models on top of it, then simply directly call our third step and initialize the models on top of your already processed data sets. And you can also use our trainer or metrics to evaluate it in a very simple way. So after these fewer introduction point, I will give you some examples to showcase how capable our model, our package PyHealth is. So this is the first example. Imagine a scenario that you wanted to simply use this open mimicry data set, but you don't want to waste the time on processing each tables. So how are you gonna do it? Simply call our install PyHealth, install our package, and then call this mimicry data set modules. So the only thing you need to do is to tell us what is the root folder of your data set. So here, we specify the folder to a synthetic mimicry data set because we are not allowed to distribute the real mimicry data set. So we have a synthetic mimic data set which has exactly the same structure just for the demo purpose. So first, you tell us the root folder. Second, tell us which tables that you wanted to process, which tables that you need in your task. And then third, whether you want to do code mapping or not. So here in this example, because the mimicry data set originally, it used this NDC coding system as the system for its drive code. Right now, we wanted to use ATC 3 level code to do some downstream task. Then we simply call our code mapping function here. So that's it. And our modules will process the mimicry data set for you. One thing to mention is that our processing functions will not lose any information. We just help you to clean up the unstructured data set and store it in a very clean structures, very easy to call structure. So how to use the process mimicry DS_DS data set? You can simply first use our stats function to check what is the statistics of each tables and the whole data set. So we will simply tell you how many patients there are in the data set, how many visits, and basically we also list other different statistics based on how many tables you want to process. And so how to use this mimicry_DS data set? You can just use this dot info function to look it up. What is it in the object? So it tells us we use mimicry_DS.patient. This is basically a dictionary. The key is a patient ID and the value is a patient object. And within that patient object, it contains a whole bunch of patient level information, such as the gender of the patient, the demographic feature of the patient, and other like the age or other different patient level information. And it also has one attribute called the visits. So this visit is itself a dictionary. The key is the visit, hospital visit ID for that patient. And the value is a visit object. So the same in this visit object, we listed whole visit level information, like the encounter time. Encounter time means the actual absolute time or the relative time this hospital visit happens. And within this visit, we have several other dictionaries mapped from the tables that you just want to process and the actual event with respect to that table. Sorry. Yes. And so for this list of event itself is an object and it contains the code for that event and whole other bunch of event level information. So in the right-hand side, I have shown a visual illustration of the whole structure. So the top level structure is different patients. Within the patient, we have different hospital visits for that patient. And within the hospital visit, we list the event for within a hospital visit. So the time is limited. Just use our package to save you some time in data processing. This is the first example. We can help you to relieve the pain of data processing. For the second example, you can imagine that if you already have the data set, then how to quickly try out models on your own data set. And so this is one example. Imagine that you already have your own training data set. You just need to process your data set into this way, into a list of samples. And each sample is basically a JSON structure. Okay, let's first look at the first sample. And then the first sample, as I mentioned, it has like patient ID and hospital visit ID and a whole bunch of visit features. For example, conditions, lab values, these are two visit features, and the labels, you give us the label. So you can imagine for this task, it probably tells us, it probably wanted to use machine learning models to use the condition features and lab value features to predict some label. For example, the label probably will be the mortality status after these hospital visits. So this is your data set. Step one, it doesn't need anything from the PyHealth package. And for step two, simply load your samples into our sample data set. Okay, very simple. Just call this sample data set. You have the data set. And then you can choose one models from our PyHealth models. It can be a transformer in this example, or it can be a LSTM, recurrent neural network, CNN, whatever. Just call the model and specify some attribute. The attributes are very clear. Tell us the data set, basically the training set, and the feature keys, like what feature you wanted to use for your machine learning model. And these keys can be a subset of the features you list here. But here we use two features, the conditions and the lab values. So they have one-to-one correspondence. Just tell us what feature you want to use and what is the target you want to predict. So here you need to specify the target of your sample. Okay, label, and tell us what task you want to model. It's a binary prediction, a multi-class prediction, or multi-label prediction, or a regression task. And that's it. So this model will return a torch.nn.module. This is simple, as like general, as simple as a like linear regression model or a simple neural network model built from PyTorch. And we have listed the structure of transformer model here. And then in the end, you can use whatever trainers or optimizer you want to train this model. And that's it. Of course, we also provide some freedom for you to customize model, such as you can specify how many layers of transformer you want to use, how many head of the transformer, and what is the dropout rate, and etc. Other different specifications is also allowed here. So this is example two. I will also show you example three, how to master the medical coding system. So in this slide, I will only play with within one coding system. So if you want to play with the ICD-9 diagnosis code, simply load that coding system, and then you can check whether a medical code is within that system. Or you can also use fuzzy lookup to see the detailed information of that code. So in different places, different scenario, you probably will see the same code, but they are formatted in different ways. For example, this 4280, it's the same as 4280, but it's written as 4280 in some other places. But our functions can help you to do fuzzy matching and then to correctly find the correct code and tell you what is that code. And we can also help you, as I mentioned before, to get the ancestors of the code, to get the siblings of the code, to get the children of the code. That basically, we basically encode the whole ontology or the structure lookup functionalities in our PyHealth. That means you can probably use our functionalities to do some graph structure type learnings, like as some application scenarios of our PyHealth. And let's look at another coding system, which is ATC. So you first load this ATC coding system, and then it enables you to look up the detailed descriptions from external resources. So for example, in this ATC coding system, I have this medical code starting from M, and you can look up its descriptions from the external database drug bank. So it tells you, okay, this code basically is the ibuprofen. You must be very familiar with this, and it's what. So we return the full descriptions of that code. And you can also look up indications of that code, and ibuprofen is something, something. So basically with these functionalities, it's possible to do some natural language pre-training tasks by your own. So for the second functions in our medical coding system, we provided the cross mapping, as I mentioned before. You just need to specify the source vocabulary, source coding system, and the target coding system, and then tell us what is the code that you wanted to look up. So this 42.80.0 is basically a code from ICD-9 diagnosis system, and you want to look up the corresponding code in a more coarse granular vocabulary, which is CCS. So it returns its corresponding like code in the CCS CM. And for another example, if you wanted to map from RX norm to the NDC code, so you want to map this code, and our return will be a list of code from NDC, because it apparently RX norm is some kind of more coarse granular code, and this code is not very specific. And then in NDC coding system, we have several code that corresponding to the code that we wanted to look at. And that's pretty much it, the examples. And I want to summarize that our PyHealth is a comprehensive deep learning toolkit designed for both machine learning researchers and healthcare practitioners. And these are the functions that we listed and I have showcased in the previous slides. We currently provide a EHR dataset modules for you to process the dataset. And we are also flexible to design different healthcare predictive tasks. They can be patient level task, intro visit level task, inter-visit level task, and unsupervised pre-trained task. And we provide different machine learning models. They can be traditional learning models, state-of-the-art models, and the transformer, GN, or CNN models. And we also provide medical coding mapping modules for you to look up a code in one coding system or to find the corresponding code in another coding system. So this is our current developing team, and we are currently frequently maintaining this package. We also like to give acknowledge to Yue Zhi Xiao and Xin Yang, who take the first step to initialize the project and build the very initial version. Although our current version is completely independent from them, we kind of implement the whole new versions from scratch, but we still want to thank them to take the first step. So here are some resources that's related to PyHealth. And so this is our PyHealth web page. Simply search for PyHealth in Google. And this is our GitHub page. And we have a contributing files in the same GitHub repos. If you are interested, just look it up and to see what else you can help. And then please contribute to our package. And to quickly get started with our package, we have write some detailed tutorials in our web pages to introduce the basic modules of the package. And we also listed some examples of how to implement the whole pipelines using our package, as well as some tutorials for advanced use case to tune different like customizable choices in our package. So thanks very much. If you have any questions, you can discuss right now.